Yeah, there's different times to exit based on what gear you get, because it all has different defense. It's the only unfortunate thing. I could try to put on a set and then change the set before Rotten does the first attack, so it's consistent, but that might be a bit too complicated, because sometimes he gets right near you depending on what attack he opens with. He might be closer. So that's a fair problem. Like that's a fair mistake. I made the opposite mistake where I actually didn't set it up properly because I was too quick. I had the timing for the gloves on the shirt, and then it didn't give me red tier stones. So I think I just have to remember, you know, get out like a fraction of a second sooner if it's the gloves. Like maybe 3.5 footsteps instead of 4, whatever it is. True, what's up? How's it going? If I didn't say hi to you. Do a barrel roll, yeah. It is good going, that's good. I am glad. Did you show up after you got hit? You did. Or we could pretend this is the first run. I think what I'm gonna do on this one, I might take a break. I definitely want more coffee. That'd be nice. I think I'll do that. Probably before we get to the Rotten again, just so I know I'm ready for it. It's your fault, True. No, it's not your fault. It's actually something that is a legitimate thing that we're going to have to learn sooner or later. Like, that was bound to happen at some point. I knew that already, but it's just not something I consciously think of often, because there's three different things you have to do depending on what armor you get earlier on. So it's all just going to be based on luck, or the drop you get. And then the time you stay in the fire, it changes based on the defense you have from that piece of gear. So the gloves is the soonest exit, pants is a little bit later, and then the chest piece has the most defense, so you actually exit exactly at the time I did right there, and we would still be alive with probably, I'd say like a sixth of the HP or something left, maybe an eighth of it left or something. Does gender affect the gameplay? It doesn't, though. How do you like your coffee, with milk or black? Most of the time, I just make it black. Like, the one that I had earlier was black, and it was warm. What I've been doing for a while, though, you just make it and then just put it in the fridge after. So, like, the rest of the stuff you make is cold, but I don't really want to wait for the first one to get cold, so. But black and cold is pretty good. Random, how goes the run? Eh. We're still learning. How are you doing? Definitely not as good as I want it to be, but that was a very valuable thing to learn. Unfortunately, it took an hour of gameplay, but it was something that I'm going to fail on later if I don't learn it now. Giuliano, I don't have a choice. I mean, if I want to do this, I have to actually be even better at resetting. Like, I have to get into the next run and play even better than I did the first time. So I'm not tilted, I'm not salty about that, but I still get salty over stupid things, so I'm still working on being able to have that mentality, because when we do the trilogy, it's going to take like probably 2 or 3 times longer than just this run took to get the first time, and there's going to be even more stuff going on that's crazy. So you just have to get back into it as quick as possible and not think about anything that just happened other than how you're going to do it better. And if you can't do anything better, then just forget about it, because it doesn't matter. Instead of complaining or just, like, worrying too much. One of the least salty people out there. There's still some people that have a level of chill that I can't really reach. Like, Colmer, for example, he's freaking crazy. He's so good. But he's also not doing this run, so I guess I'm kind of ahead in terms of experience. So I guess some people, once they choose to do things this crazy, it's kind of up to that. But for the regular no-hit runs in SL1 on DS1, Colmer is pretty chill. been playing DS2 for a week and you get till real quick. You get mad real quick, is that what you're trying to say? Can you kick? So you can't kick, but you do a guard break with your hand. Oh, tilted. Okay, I see. Yeah, I'd say dying anywhere from like 500 to 1,000 times on the first playthrough, and this is pretty average. I'd probably even expect more than 1,000 deaths if you're playing all three DLCs. But, I mean, it doesn't matter though. Like, you could do it in 100, you could do it in 1,000. You're gonna learn eventually, the more you play it, how to do stuff better. And that's gonna change depending on how you choose to go through the game and what items you use and all that, you know. It's a lot of variety. Rex, I'll see you later, man. Take care. Thank you for asking. Frank Sinatra. I had a lot of Frank Sinatra on the old playlists. It's a good reminder, though. I should add him to the new one, or this one. The thing is, the singing is just kind of... It crowds the audio space, really. I need stuff that's just instruments without percussion, particularly. Or voices. Unless it's, very mild, just because, like, when I talk, it kind of just distracts me. And then if I'm talking over someone singing, it's also harder to listen to what I'm saying for you guys if it's loud enough. So while he is a good artist, I think I'll probably put it on the regular playlist. DS2 is way too slow. When you play it enough, honestly, the slowness of it, like, you just get used to it. But when you go back and forth between the other games, yeah, it's ridiculous how slow it is. I think the only thing that actually is the same speed as some of the other games is, like, the running speed in this is pretty much the same as DS1. But the other actions are pretty slow. How long do you think the trilogy will take? It could take till the end of this year. Honestly, I don't know. I'd estimate it'll take longer than it took to get the original trilogy. So if we just say, let's say it takes twice the amount of time of that, it'll be at least 4 months or so. You just watched the Magnum Opus upload? What the fuck? Yeah, it's crazy, dude. It is so impressive. I feel like Ghost Sagan should have got way more attention for that, like that. But I guess people just know that he's crazy in that community. I don't know. I'm sure, but I guess it got quite a bit of views. It should have millions, though. It should be like 10 million views for that. What's your favorite Souls, and what would be your favorite From Software game? Favorite From Soft game, Sekiro. Favorite Souls game is Bloodborne, if you count that. You hate how long it takes to go through a fog wall, yeah. What's Magnum Opus? It's a Mario Maker 1 level from Ghost Sagan. Base stamina is really low. The stamina consumption is just greater per actions, and it replenishes slower. So just like the conversion of using stamina and then like actions themselves take way too much. And there's a penalty where you lose iframes if you roll the soonest you can when one tick of stamina comes back, at least, or just like a little bit. You will not have any iframes on that particular roll as a penalty, which the other games doesn't have. Go on and see. Can't beat Bloodstarved Beast N1. Try the Beast cocktails, or the Pungent Blood cocktails on it. That helps quite a bit, if you have any of those. Man, I wish you could just jump down this part right here. You'd probably die. I think you need the ladle. Squally, what's up? How's it going, man? How are you doing today? I canceled the gate, apparently. console? Me? I'm using PC. Personally. Unless we're talking about something else. If you need to be within render distance for crops to grow or not, specifically sugarcane. Oh, you're talking about Minecraft? Okay. I don't know anything about that. That sounds pretty crazy, actually, though. So you're making, you made a thing, or a space so big that you have to go closer to an object to get it to do its function, because it doesn't register. It doesn't actually appear unless you're close enough to it.
Let strength be granted, so the world might be ended.
So the world... I must love it, Demon. This is my favorite game of all time.
What's popping?
Kappa. Solar, thank you for the 2 months. Welcome back. I appreciate it. How's it going? Only happens in the radius of the player. That's so crazy. So you have to stay by it if you want it to grow. You don't have a choice. You can't go too far away. He is in the wall. It's not really good. Why are you doing this, dude? Just give me the sweep. Do I use a gaming chair? Do I think they're worth it? I've never had a gaming chair before. BB has a gaming chair, though. It's too small for me. I think it's made for people that are probably, like, under 6 feet, maybe, like, 5'8 to 5'10. Because my head goes over where the headrest's max position is. It's like the headrest is on, the, like, below my neck. And then the armrests are really uncomfortable. This chair I'm using right now is just, like, a basic mesh chair. And then my chair is a... just an office kind of chair. It's pretty basic, but yeah, I've never had a gaming one. I was thinking of talking to DX Racer and asking them if they'd be interested in doing like a sponsored thing, but I feel like you have to do face cam for that. They've been at an event that I go to regularly as well many times, but they always leave before I can get to them because I'm always talking to other people, and then I try to find them last and they're gone, so I gotta figure out if they're going to the next event near where I live, and I could just talk to them there. How tall am I? I'm 6'2", so it's kind of hard to find chairs that are like that, where you can adjust it. I think there's a specific DX Racer model. I think Cheese has it. I tried it at his house. I forget what the model is called, but it's made for people that are taller. The basic one is way too small, though. I forget what the name of it is, the model. It's got a cool name. Dorksil, what's up? How's it going? Cheese, the Mario 64 guy? No, Cheese Wiz. He's a variety streamer. Also, one second. Let's not screw this up. Here's your luck. Take it back. Thanks for the loan. Taxing, that's why I screwed up the fire, man. It's all your fault. No, I'm kidding. That was definitely like a skill thing, but... I hope you enjoyed the luck while I gave it to you. We're loaning out luck now. How hard is it to not be greedy? Sometimes it's pretty hard to not be greedy, even if you are understanding. How tall are you in centimeters? Apparently 188. I don't know. But, I was wrong. I thought I was 180, but apparently it's 188 centimeters. Toxic, thank you for the Prime sub. I hope you enjoy your emotes. Welcome. How's it going, Toxic? That's all three. We're good. Cool. I feel spicy, so I'm just gonna open this. Been watching YouTube for ages. Nice to finally catch one live. Thank you for watching the stream live. I appreciate it. Hope you've enjoyed it so far as well. This is an interesting run to watch. An interesting time to be in the channel for the first time, but there's a chance we actually can get this, so at least you're not gonna see me learning this run as much as just trying to attempt it now. And that's good. Can definitely expect us to get pretty far. at least every day, we'll get pretty far. But I am planning to beat it today. Talking about height again, Xerox? Someone was asking about my height. I was saying that DX Racers, the base model, is not really made for tall people, but there is one that they have that is good for tall people. So if I was going to get one of those, I would get that version of it. ...185, y'all are so tall, Callista. Well, it's just gonna keep happening, like, as the future goes on. The kids, they're eating, the GMOs and everything today. They're gonna, and the tranquilizers chicken, the growth hormone chicken. Gonna be, like, 7 feet tall on average. It's like a shift in genetic capability. How tall is Baby? She's taller than average height. I think she's like 5'7", maybe. Maybe 5'8". How many attempts have I done till now, Matt? I don't actually have a counter to count the total attempts. We've been working on this run for probably 3 weeks or so, from learning it to actually being able to get zero on it now. Don't knock the barrel, dude. What is going on? Who is this guy? What is his deal? Oh, he's going for the grab. Weirdo with the grab. She's tall too. She's definitely a little taller than average, but not super, super tall though. Can I get the barrel still on this? Surprise. Hardest part of this run, Matt, would be Throne Watcher and Defender. You are a GMO. 167 here, not the tallest dude in Brazil, but not so short still. 167 centimeters, how much is that in feet? Watcher and Defender rocks. They're a good boss fight for the game, but for this run, they suck. It's basically just run away and don't get clipped on something dumb. And also don't die to gravity. And also don't choose to shoot the crossbow at the wrong time, because it takes a year to recover from it. And it uses a lot of stamina, too. Let strength be granted. Whereas, at least on the regular character, the commitment to using the regular bow is much less. It's quicker and it takes less stamina. And you have more stamina. And you have iframes, so it's just wonderful. Sad Horseman, thank you for the 7 months. Welcome back. How's it going, dude? I'm doing pretty good. How are you? Sir Alone? Oh boy. Am I a souls or born like? I'm a meme, dude. I'm a meme in a dream. On a stream. Okay. Now we're going here. Throne Watcher and Defender are really easy with a summon. Oh, probably. I think they wanted you to co-op on that. Because I think even on a regular character, on a first playthrough, I died quite a bit to them. They were pretty hard. I also most likely didn't know about ADP. But, yeah. 5'6"? Okay. Can't wait for your brother to come back home. He's bringing the PS4. One second. Let's put both of these on. And we're good. He's bringing PS4, which means it's time for Bloodborne. Oh, he's letting you play Bloodborne. Nice. That's cool. That's exciting, man. There's actually a Bloodborne tournament next week, I think it is. Or the week after. I think it's not this coming weekend, but next weekend. We're going to be practicing for it next week, so I got to get this run before that. It's the goal. Are summons allowed in this? In this run, no. No summons. To be fair, summons would make it harder for a lot of things. And then also, I mean, if the summon gets hit, then that's like something got hit at least, so it's It's debatable if that counts, if they can get hit by enemies, but you can't. It's basically like having like a bodyguard. But I think the attention being split for bosses makes them more confusing sometimes. Is Sekiro dead? What do you mean by dead? Depends on your definition of that. Gino, thanks for the good luck, man. Are you thinking of trying this again? Redoing the SL1 trilogy. Oh boy. Where's the ladder? There it is. I actually found the ladder this time. You're gonna do DS2 in a bit? Okay, cool. Hob is actually, he's streaming the trilogy SL1 on August 5th, apparently. But someone told me he didn't actually practice it off stream, so I'm wondering what that's gonna be like. He's actually really good at DS2, so I'm wondering what he thinks about this run. Zero hit all bosses plus DLC summons only. Dude, some of the DLC summons are terrible. Like that lady with the fist weapons, the Cestuses. I forget what her name. She has a really weird name too. But they're so bad. They don't even do damage, and she just dies every time. It's almost like they're thinking that part of the difficulty of the DLC would be making the summons really bad. Quick tip, don't wrap a wrist support around your arm too tight or you will lose the feeling in your hand within 30 minutes. That's definitely a good call. Top tier, man. Alright. The hype died pretty quickly. Sekiro can't be dead. It's not alive. It's a game. Well, it depends on the context. If you mean like active players on a platform playing it daily, or if you mean like traffic to like the directory on Twitch, there's probably quite a lot of people still actively playing it. But in terms of people streaming it, it's fairly dead. Yeah. He kind of just went through the wall a little bit. That was weird. 1,830 on Steam. That's kind of low, actually. I think there's 8,000 on DS2, apparently. Like, according to what we were looking at yesterday. Daily average is 3,400. Oh, wow. He doesn't have as much replayability, though, so that makes sense. I would expect it to be higher, though. You love Sekiro, just almost no replayability, which is sad for a casual player. DS3 is almost 6k. It's pretty impressive. Yeah, that's true. Multiplayer stuff is, it's gonna have more activity. How do you check how many players are on the game? I think you can go into the info if you like right click the game, go to like the community page, something like that, or you can go to Steam charts. I feel like you can see it from the Steam app as well, but yeah, I'm not sure how I've done that before for something. I think I checked Absolver one time. Simon, thank you for the good luck. I appreciate it. Skyrim's 10k, Terraria's 26,000. How often do they update Terraria? Skyrim has infinite well, it's got the mod support, so it's always gonna be updated in some way, right? I wonder how many people are playing it for the first time out of that number, though. That's something I'm curious of. Had its last update this year. Oh no. It's over. You can right-click a game and go to view community hub, and you can see how many are in-game. Okay, community hub, that's what it's called. There we go. Neo, Sekiro, Lords of the Fallen, any other games like Souls? Are you asking me if I like them? Lords of the Fallen was okay. Neo, I don't like. There's not many other Souls-like games I've played that are big budget. I mean, like, Death's Gambit? Death's Gambit was inspired, but it's not really the same kind of genre. It's a platformer. Can't listen to music without a subwoofer anymore. That bass. If I can't feel the music in my bones, it doesn't count. Didn't like Neo. Okay, String, you know I don't like Neo. You knew that that's the case. You totally knew that. That guy's scaring the hell out of me, actually. I don't know if I should have done that. Or I gotta react sooner on the recovery. The Surge? I don't like the Surge. From the looks of it. I'm not into sci-fi like that, where you're killing robots. Unless there's some sort of crazy twist to it, maybe, but... Yeah, the Surge is just not my style. Cory in the house for DS. Is that actually a game? Dude, there's probably people that speedrun that. If that's real, there's definitely speedrun records on YouTube. We played Shovel Knight? No, I missed out on that. I've seen Barbed speedrun Shovel Knight though. Did I play Hollow Knight? No, I didn't play Hollow Knight. I might play the second one. I've seen pretty much everything in Hollow Knight. You can see dozens of times just because my one friend speedran it for the record. And then I watched the DLC when it came out. On Faraz's channel. Lords of the Fallen is clunky. It's very slow. It's definitely very slow. Play Room. What is... Oh, Doom. Doom's not really my style. I'm not into the arcadey shooters. I like competitive shooting games. Or like the multiplayer ones. Are you about to die? We definitely don't have a lot of health left, so... Pretty close to it, fall damage-wise. I definitely don't want to fall off something too tall. Have you played Rainbow Six? I haven't. But I've watched some of it. It looks pretty cool. I think it would have been cool to play if there was the right people to play it with when it came out, for sure. But, yeah, I've watched it a little bit. Dishonored? Dishonored is not something that I like that much, no. I played it, though. I did play Dishonored. Dying Light, can't wait for the second one to come out. I watched my friend play Dying Light. I think he let me try it too. And then I watched a lot of streamers play that. But I didn't know there was a second one though. That's really good RNG. That's the best RNG we've gotten in a while on that. Nice. I'll take it. This music? Yeah. Hey, I like this music. It's good. It's perfect for that fight, right? Castlevania? Never beaten the Castlevania before. Played some of them, though. I was told Symphony of the Night is really good. Yeah. You enjoyed Dying Light? You'll probably play, too. How to Survive, too? Is that a game? Got bullied by survivors in zombie mode. Is that multiplayer Dying Light? Or something else? Hackers and glitches. I didn't even know there's multiplayer on it. I thought you were talking about Dead by Daylight at first. Or, Dead by Daylight, that's what it's called. Dying Light and Dead by Daylight get confused a lot for me. Sick, what's up? You were ranked as an indisputable Apex Predator. Wow. Quite the title. One zombie versus an amount of survivors, although you do get bullied by survivors in DBD as well. I wonder if Dying Light multiplayer took or was inspiration for Dead by Daylight. Or is it the same studio that made both? Like, there wasn't any multiplayer games like Dead by Daylight that I had seen before when that originally came out. And then they did the Friday the 13th one, right? Evolve is, yeah, it's definitely a similar format, you're right. I played Evolve for a little bit as well while it was free. Dude, I didn't even kill a single dude here. I actually would benefit more from just doing this again. There's not even a point of trying to waste the bolts. That bowling ball was a gutter. Imagine playing tseldora bowling, where it's like the more enemies you actually get, the better your score is, and then you have to compete with somebody else. That could be a good tiebreaker for a DS2 hitlist tournament. Just load tseldora and play bowling. Please. Only two. Really? I can't even go for him. That's not worth it. No, you haven't heard in years. I am pooped. Like when someone's tired. Got the gloves. Okay. Can we get the pants, maybe? Will we? That guy's death position looks like it's impossible, but apparently he died like that. Do I exist in real life, Appreciator? Maybe. That's up for you to decide. Must have no-hit this game before, Idiocatch? With a leveled character, yeah, I have before. I'm almost curious of how fast our time would be on a leveled character now, because that road is quicker than SL1, and I think my SL1 time is close to what my original, or it's faster than my original run was the first time I no-hit DS2. My trilogy DS2 was under 2 hours, I think. Oh no, it wasn't. My trilogy DS2 wasn't under 2 hours. It was actually, I think it was around, it was a little faster than this. It was like 215, so yeah, I could probably get like a 140 to 150 leveled run. I'm gonna wear the pants on this one, I think. Oh, I didn't get it though. I got the shirt, that's what it was. Yeah, we'll do the gloves again. Just be careful on the fire. the ladle, though. Okay, we're good. Yeah. Almost a good fight until I scuffed it. Or partially scuffed it. Didn't realize it was SL1. Idio catch? Yeah, this is SL1. At the moment. Never done that before. Jack, doing okay. Not too bad. I made it to the rotten and then I died to fire. Because I timed the roll out of the fire like I had the jacket on. The peasant's gear that we had picked up, but I had got the gloves, which has less defense, so I have to roll out of the fire sooner to get red tier stone ring when it comes to farming the rotten. Do you just go here for the ascetic? Yes, the ascetic and then also the titanite to get my weapon to plus 10. And then get the crossbow to plus 7. How's it possible for SL1 being faster than the regular one? It's because the route when I did the original DS2 no hit run, and then even the trilogy was just slower. Like, I just played the game slower. I chose to do things less efficient. Like, I just know the game better now because I've been doing this. I've tried to make things a little bit speedier. And Papa Finn also has a really, really quick way of doing things. So some of the stuff that he helped me with is you can apply that to a regular character as well. That would save us some time. How's it possible to SL1 be fast? Yeah, so I reread that, damn it. Yeah, it's kind of like with all the games. If I went back and I did, if I looked at my SL1 DS1 no-hit run, it would also be slower than how I play it now. Just simply because the more you play it, you just find more little things that you can optimize, or just things that you can get more comfortable with that are scarier things to do. You get better at them, and then you can just save more time. You just get better overall. Get better at reading chat while playing, you know? Just get better at doing a lot of autopiloting, the easier stuff. There's so many little things that get better. But basically, I could have played it that fast all along. I just didn't really focus on the speed right away, and I would have less consistency and be less comfortable doing it quickly way back in time, right? Because I was trying to just get the no-hit for the first time ever on this game. Whereas now it's for a bigger project where I kind of need each game to go fast and efficiently so I can do it in one stream. Pretty speedrunning now. Not even really speedrunning, just like more efficient overall. And comfortable. That's what it is. Do you know practice is cheating? Yeah, if you don't do this run first try ever in your entire life, it's actually cheating. Love that you have to light the torch at the bonfire. I think that's pretty cool too. Let's actually buy these first. Oh, wait, I got an extra chunk so I can get plus 8 early. That's pretty cool. That's just random. Now we gotta go to... Flexile again. Jump attack on the Titanite Lizard is satisfying. Yeah, if you get a baby jump there, though, you're just dead, so... You gotta make sure you get the big jump. It's pretty easy to get a big jump there, but I have actually got the shitty jump before. I think I had also got one where I killed the lizard but fell off the cliff. Like, the weapon hit the ground, but my body wasn't over the floor completely. Is the mace all the way through the run? I used the mace the entire time. That's the only weapon next to the crossbow, yeah. Only melee weapon. Why the mace? It's just the best weapon for soul level 1. I can't use anything else other than the broadsword. Broadsword, longsword, foot soldier sword, and the hatchet. And those are all worse than this. At least when we're thinking of weapons we can just get right at the beginning of the game. Longsword's also a little bit risky to go for if you go for the fire one, and Foot Soldier Sword takes forever to farm sometimes, so... Most convenient and most powerful, good stun lock as well. Strike weapons are good against armored enemies, which are most of them. Yeah, that's true, that's very true. What's behind the statue guy in the sewer area? The statue guy. Did we go by him? Oh, that's probably just like an item or something. I don't actually remember. It's not an area, it's just an item. Of some sort. Yeah, it's the one that we ran by in the little hallway cutout, right? Yeah, he should fall off. The ladle, so if you type in exclamation point peasant in chat, that'll explain, or if someone wants to do that. It's probably the most important thing to understand about SL1 before anything else is really asked. Voodoo, what's up? I think I could get this guy from right here, actually, pretty safe. Before we actually get close to this part. Oh, he actually hit the ridge right there. That's weird. He wasn't high up enough. One more frame, total cheating, Grimbert. Oh, it's a straight hack, man. We figured out that the game allows you to get an extra stat, which is obviously boosting, which is cheating. Does one extra iframe help that much? Oh yeah, it's worth it. It's definitely worth it. 8 iframes is extremely low. Even 9 is pretty low, but 9 is always better. Like even 10 would be better than 9. It's just up to around maybe 12, and then you're on par with the other games. By default, except DS1, you can get 15 if you get Darkwood Granary, which is the highest frames for SL1. Yeah, it's not really 1/60th of a second because the terms for the frames are done in 30 FPS. So in that context, it's actually 2 out of 60, technically. Or the duration of 2 frames within a 60-second animation. Per iframe, or per frame of anything. Because you have to consider... It doesn't make... Like, if it was that way, then that means that playing in 60 FPS would be harder to roll. So... It's more like 2 out of 60 added. The amount of... The timing you have to actually evade something is 0.3 of a second with 9 frames. in this. That's how it works. And normally it's around 0.4 of a second or higher. With the 12 frames. I guess we don't want the chess piece. How do people know it's 9 iframes? You can just go into the game on PC and like you could even count the frames if you slowed down footage. Of where invulnerability ends, like on getting roll call, for example. But there's general rules that work as there's a startup, a recovery for like parries, for example, with a parry window. I think in this you have iframes at the beginning of the animation, then there's the cooldown. But yeah, people test a lot of stuff and then they make the wikis for it and all that. It's not too hard to test that kind of stuff with a computer. It's pretty simple stuff. Just sounds fancy. Slow motion. There's also, I think, there's the double speed and like the slowdown tool for, as a mod for even the other games, right? And this one. So you could use that. But I'm sure it's coded as well. It's probably in the source code somewhere. You ring the bell with a bow? Yep, that's pretty much. That's pretty PogChamp. Dismortis, thank you for the good luck. I appreciate it. I appreciate it, man. I kind of feel like if we take a really quick break on this, I don't want to go to the BRB screen. I kind of just want to leave it at Majula, at the fire, and then leave the music on. So I'm going to take a break once we get to Rotten Farming, once we start the Majula part of it, and then we'll be good for the rest of the stream.
Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. So the world might be mended.
Vulcanus, thank you for the 23 months. Welcome back, man. How's it going? Griff, thank you for the 19 months. Welcome back as well. What's up, dude? Are you ready for the most riveting time of your life? Featuring dude wearing one wristband that actually just has carpal tunnel and looks generic as fuck. All right, let's get the stone ring on before I forget this, because our weight is actually perfect to keep it on. Not to get rid of any armor or anything like that. Been screwing up this part with the dogs quite a bit. Because I just fire there. I just need more stamina, that's all it is. What was that? It kind of just poked its head out. Doing good, how the runs? They could be a bit better, but I learned something earlier, so that was good. Definitely looking to get a run better than yesterday by the end of this. I just want to get it, man. I just want to make it to the end again. Practice throwing Watcher Defender quite a bit. Past few days. I actually played the end game before we started yesterday, and it went really well, so... did Nishandra as well as Throne Watcher and Defender. Been trying to make that a thing before we start. Okay, so here is where we're gonna go back to Majula. Musashi, what's up? How's it going? So we're gonna take a break. I'm not gonna put on like the BRB screen, which is kind of just like a GIF of Solaire right now, since I'm not on my computer. I don't have the actual BRBs. I'm gonna sit at Majula, and we're gonna leave the music on. I'm gonna turn it up a little bit, and I will be back. If anyone asks, I'm taking a break. And Cody, what's up? How's it going? So yeah, I will be back. I'm just gonna get some coffee and eat and stuff like that. Thank you for hanging out so far. If you have enjoyed the stream, here's the Twitter to know when I go live. And here's the YouTube as well. Definitely check those out if you have interest in those things. It's pretty cool. And I'll be back.
Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. So the world might be mended.
Alright guys, I'm back. Thank you for being patient. I appreciate it. That's a lot of ease, by the way. That is an extremely big amount of ease. Geeko, thank you very much for the 10-month resub. Welcome back, man. Sorry, I kind of missed that right as I took a break. Also, Ronaldo, thank you for the bits, man. Kazoodle, is this really the vanilla version of DS2? This is Scholar. I'll sometimes use the other directory as well. So, it is definitely always going to be Scholar. Alright, let's do the Rotten Split. Just for fun? It was a better opportunity. So basically, whatever category has more viewers is what I'll pick. For any game that has multiple directories. Sometimes I'll do that with Bloodborne DLC directory if it's being boosted a lot and I'm going to be playing the DLC. It just really depends. Like, I think Karmic was playing speedruns earlier, so I just put it on that because he's bringing it up by like 1,400 people. Streamer 101 tips. The strategy. I don't know if he's on anymore. If this directory has less viewers, then I'll switch it. But it probably doesn't matter. A lot of people speedrun the vanilla DS2, so it's likely that there's going to be people that are looking for that kind of stuff. And it is the case that there is more streamers actually actively doing runs on the vanilla game, that I've seen at least, so. They were interrupted to do the E's count. You can use the E command, so 53 E's was not beaten apparently. But next time, I implore you to beat the 53 E's. Don't think the game's bad, but this is the one DS that you had to take a break from, Dorps. I've taken a fair amount of breaks from it myself. There's actually quite a lot of time in the channel where I didn't really even play it, like, for a long, long time, so. I think once I started doing the trilogy again is when I brought back DS2, but I'm not sick of it yet, so that's good. I really want to get this run. I've kind of mastered the art of it's fine, which means you basically just say it's fine. And you continue and you smile and that's it. No complaining. Maybe a little bit of speculation of why you made a mistake or why the game was being weird, but just continue to play and don't get too tilted. And that's it. That's basically what I'm doing. That's all you can do. Otherwise, it's going to be a terrible experience. You'll try that next time. I think it's up to, like, if you're playing the game casually, definitely only keep playing if you're having fun. I mean, it's going to be frustrating at times, but if you can't find any more fun in it at all, like in any single way, any enjoyment, no matter how hard you try, even if you do succeed on the things you're stuck on, then that's a little bit different. The meme where the dog is in the house and it's on fire is the mood for DS2. That's pretty much, yeah, that's what it is. You lose controllers the other way, yeah. I'm gonna take a picture for Twitter and for the Discord of my controller collection. And I'm gonna break some broken controllers one day. Maybe on stream, we'll see. Can we ban these people, the E-people? Yeah, I try to not do the E's while we're actually here. When I'm on break, though, I can understand. You can talk about whatever you want, but... We should keep the E-train to a minimum when I'm actually speaking to chat. I think that's a good idea. Although, I think those E's were actually achieved when I was doing the trilogy. And chat was really fast, so it kind of accumulated quickly. No ease during Dark Souls office hours. There you go. During office hours. Just ban everybody. I always find it funny when there's those streamers that ban people that don't even do anything wrong just because they're salty. It's like, someone asks a question, it's like, I'm banning you. I remember that was my experience in the, one of the first streams I watched. There was a guy that was really salty because his computer was broken or something. And I asked him if he was going to play Dark Souls 1, because I knew that he had speedran it for a while, because I'd seen his YouTube. And he banned me because I asked about Dark Souls 1, which is apparently a rule. And I didn't see that anywhere. It was in his panels, but I didn't know you can't ask about Dark Souls 1 or you get banned. So that's what happened. It wasn't Faraz. It wasn't anybody that you guys would know. I think he's mainly a Dota streamer now. But he was a really old Dark Souls 1 speedrunner. It was just really funny. I could not believe he did that because of the computer being broken. How many viewers did he have? Probably like 30 or something like that. Not too many. This wasn't a big streamer. This was kind of like a smaller streamer. But enough where he could particularly pick out the situation. And then tell me I was getting banned, you know. I think if he was busier, then it wouldn't be recognized that much. Or he'd have to have a better way of handling things. Because he can't just go and ban everybody. For reasons like that, when you have a lot of viewers, but... Well, I guess it would just take a lot of time, right? Unless he had moderators do it. Raid him? I don't even know if he streams anymore. I don't want to raid him, because he did that. I would have if he I still liked what he was doing and he never did that, I would probably host him, but not anymore though. Speedrunners are salty. There's some really cool speedrunners. I wouldn't generalize them, but there are some speedrunners that I've met that are not that nice. I don't think it has to do with speedrunning all the time. I think it's just people that are just silly people regardless, right? They just happen to speedrun as well, but I'd say there's more cool speedrunners than not, but Dark Souls speedrunners in particular are a lot different from what I've seen compared to people like that play other games like Ocarina of Time runners or Super Mario 64 runners, Metroid, stuff like that. like those guys seem to be a little bit different, a little bit more chill maybe. But then again, I don't know every single Dark Souls speedrunner. Like I said, I know a lot of people that are really cool as well. Just there's been some people that are pretty salty for sure. I've been pretty salty before. I'm definitely salty sometimes. Ever watch people streaming DS nowadays, or do you play it so much you're sick of it? I watch people stream once in a while. I don't watch a lot of streams, but mainly that means I watch a lot of different people, but only for like a very small amount of time. So I think I watched Tezor stream for like 10 minutes yesterday. And then I watched I watched Barb this morning for 15 minutes. And then there's times where I'll have people on in the background, but that's pretty much it. Like it's just quick, kind of, you know, while I'm getting ready to stream or when I'm in between doing something else, or you know, if I want to listen to somebody and do something at the same time. He just came from Barb's stream. Is he still alive right now? He's still making levels. All right, let's do this. Gotta be quick. Oh, the freaking prompt for the menu. That slows you down enough where that could be make or break. I could screw this up now because of that. Because the button didn't work right away. Okay, we actually have pretty good timing, so I might be fine. Yeah, I'm fine. Okay, he's a little slow there. See, I pressed the thing for the bomb and nothing happens. Holy shit, that was scary. Oh, please, please don't die. Please don't die. That freaked me the hell out. Dude, like, I pressed the button and nothing happened there. I was just standing. Holy shit. Okay, no RTSR. We're gonna have to get used to that, unfortunately. I'm still not used to the glove setup. Or the defense that the glove gives me against the fire. To set up RTSR. There's one more tick on the lava too much. If I took one more footstep in the lava and then rolled, I'd be dead. That's what I did last time. So I have to find like this in-between timing or be more on the outside of the where the lava is, like closer to the ground. Oh, did I not used to use RTSR on a leveled character for this? I think that command is from a while back when I was originally doing DS2. That's probably from like 2017 or something. Wow. That's old. Yeah, I would totally always go for the fire now, but we gotta be careful with it still. And I also have to spam the bomb there to get it to work, or it doesn't work right away all the time. Apparently. Thank you. It's about this situation. Read carefully, Combine. Oh, the command. Can we ban me, Lullerman? I don't know about that. Berensky, what's up? How's it going? I gotta move over a little bit. The cable for this controller is short. Okay. Just in time for your favorite section, farming. Yay. Exciting. Super awesome. Anyway, we can make it sound interesting, right? Now, the split is definitely not the greatest, but it's not the worst either. It's actually not my least favorite segment. Having a Black Lagoon marathon. What is Black Lagoon? I've never heard of that. Yeah, the only thing about this split is I can't really like read chat that much, but it's alright though. We'll make it.
You guys gotta believe.
If we can break his arm this time. I love the arm breaks. It's pretty good RNG, actually. I'm gonna get him back over here a little bit. What rotten are we on? You just got back from hiking. How was your hike floating? How's it going, man? I love hiking. Good call. Yeah, that's the third. This is going to be the fourth coming up. This is the last one. And we actually get to use a bright bug, so it's not as bad. I think it'll be a bit quicker than the one we just did. Watch out for the weirdo in the water with his staff of Catholicism. That probably is the... Yeah, that's the name, Catholicism. You're right. I think I read that wrong yesterday when you said that. Or somebody... Was it... Yeah, it was you that said it, right? Somebody said that. Have you heard of Massima? I don't know what that is. You like the DS2 bosses, but not the rest of the game? You like all the bosses? Really? That's interesting. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Was not good. A little bit slow there. Oh, he's getting stuck though. I said Catholicism. I am stupid. Sorry. I just didn't read it slow enough. Catholicism is actually the name though. Okay, last rotten. What the hell was that? This is really good RNG. Oh my god. He wants us to win. Or he wants us to think we've won and then do something weird, right? That's what you'd think. Switch you around over here. Now I'm just stuck. Okay, let's rotate you a little bit. Okay, oh, he's bringing back the arm, damn it. Devin, what's up? How's it going? Devin, but with 420 hour ult. Oh god. Looks like there's peanuts scattered around this area. Those bodies. Those body cask of things. There's peanuts. Maybe they were hungry. They were just eating. GG on the fast menuing. I kind of have to have it quickly for the armor switch, though. Especially if we have to wear the chest piece for the peasant set and we don't get lucky and get the gloves or the pants. Because that means I can't wear four rings. I have to wear three rings whenever I'm fighting a boss or running through an area. Or my equip load is too heavy. But with the other ones, they're light enough, so I don't have to worry about that. Also, wait, I'm supposed to have a second bonfire here. I never actually lit that one, apparently. I guess you don't typically need to because we don't homeward bone, but yeah, I should have lit that at least. That's weird. In case like Forlorn invades, right? I don't have the one after this area though. Hmm. We got the +8 on the bow early, which is good. Why farm rotten and not another boss? Because it's the quickest run back that's the safest, and he's pretty simple to kill. The only boss easier than him out of the ones you can actually farm would be Freya, but Freya, the run back is pretty difficult, and you can get Forlorn invasions there. Whereas Forlorn can invade. There's nothing that can really interrupt us getting to the rotten, unless I screw up the statues. So, just very quick. Is it technically possible to do a no damage taken run? Yes, you could. It's just more tedious. It's a little bit less fun than this. Probably less interesting to watch. But I've done them on Dark Souls 3. And then I think Ostarva did one on this game before as well. I'm sure some other people have tried it. It's just a lot of... You got to get this spell that reduces fall damage and then... I think that before you get that, I don't even know when you can get it, but I don't think you can do the gutter. I think you have to do Freya for the farming. So the spider, big spider. I should probably switch to Stone Ring, right? Have you ever done no hit in real life, Idiocatch? No. I don't believe so. That'd be pretty hard. You'd have to be like in a in a safe environment with no safety hazards and no fun, unfortunately. Ever done deathless? Well, I think everybody's on a deathless run until they're not, right? Hateless in real life for years. No, you never stubbed, you haven't like stubbed your toe or like scratched yourself or something. No injuries, really. Wow. Spooky spells. Yeah, I think, is it called spook in this game as well? Pog. Devin, thank you for the four doll hairs and 20 cents. I appreciate it. That was a funny alert. Pog. Because it matches the guy that's freaking out. Oh, that's instant RTSR, apparently. Nice. Oh, we don't have the gloves on, though. There we go. Someone probably noticed that. Do you have Legos, Berensky? Do I have... Oh, yeah, like, stepping on Legos? It's, like, the most painful thing ever. Okay, we're gonna have to pay attention to this guy. Because he is a goober, indeed. He's like, I don't want to go up there to kill you, but I'm gonna have to, and then I run down. That'd be a creepy question to ask somebody. You want some doll hairs? Was really close. I had no choice but to do that. He was being really weird. Sometimes their AI is like, it's undecisive with the walking, so it just walks back and forth in the middle of the path. You need there to be open space. They also roll catch you, so they'll roll to make you panic, and then if you roll when they roll, then they hit you with the roll attack on the dagger, unfortunately. But he didn't do that there. He just attacked, which was good. So In the trilogy, if this game comes later than the first, I'll actually probably kill that ghost, or at least I'll try to kill him more often than not. So there's a chance that we can avoid anything weird over there, but I should also get practice doing it like that too. Because you can totally dodge their attacks, they're just really weird with how they choose to do things. Actually, wait, I need this still. Lydios, thank you for the good luck. I appreciate it. He sells Legos from the back of a truck? Really? Bootleg Lego? This underground Lego scene blowing up. Oh boy. I probably could shoot this guy once before we get over here, then just finish him. Or we just bank on him doing that. That's always nice. Why do you always jump down at the beginning to lower the health? It gives me more damage. So red tier stone ring. This ring right here. Boost attack when HP is low. 20% is the boost. Banking inconsistent. Well, I mean, like, he can do... I know the other things he can do as well, which are fine, but what he did right there was nice. Because if he fired a second time on the crossbow, I'd have to wait longer, and then it's harder to be as quick with the positioning and everything, and usually you want to hit him before he hits you. That's the main priority. Like, doing the area all over again is worth it if you save yourself, but that was good positioning to just get the door right away. I think wood grain ring is OP in DS3. I don't think there is a wood grain ring in DS3, Daniel. Are you talking about the blood ring? Or wood grain in DS1? RTSR looks ugly in this, yeah. A little bit. Switch these really quick. We shouldn't need the buff on this, but just to be careful in case something weird happens. You did Gale Hateless, you didn't hit him once. Oh boy. I think that I kind of like the animation of RTSR and the character, but the ring itself, yeah, it doesn't look as good. Wood grain ring in DS3, but it's only found in New Game Plus. Oh, increases weapon durability. Oh, my bad. Not dark wood grain ring. Wood grain ring. Okay. Yeah, probably not a big deal. You think DS3 has rain? No, I don't think it does. You're correct, man. What's up with that? Why doesn't it have rain? Huh? Why can't they afford rain for DS3? It's a big budget game, huh? Millions of copies sold. Can't afford rain. What's going on, Miyazaki? Become all cool with your streak of amazing games you've designed, and then you just don't put rain in one of them? This is an outrage. Okay, we should be able to go back right away. Wooden matches, so expensive, it's funny. Wood grain is from new game. Yeah, dark wood is old. Or, sorry, dark wood's from DS1. Wood grain is DS3. They're different. I forgot about that. Isn't there like a Eastwood grain ring in DS1 that's for durability? Or some Eastern ring thing, whatever it's called. Are you leveling the ladle? No, I was about to by accident, actually. But we're not supposed to, though. I was just looking for the crossbow in the menu. Should throw on these. DS3 can't afford romantic subplots. What the hell, Miyazaki? Well, it's got the Henri thing, the whole stabbing in the face. That's pretty good. If I was a DS enemy, who would I be, Lawlerman? I'd probably like to be a Grave Warden. Those are my favorite enemies. Not in this game, but the Grave Wardens in DS3. With the twin blades. I feel like it'd be really cool doing that. They're so fast, and they can breathe fire as well, I think, right? Or they do like crazy blowtorch tricks. You can literally marry Henri? What the fuck? You don't know about the stabbing? Yeah, you can. You actually end up putting a knife in her face or something like that. Timmy, what's up? Which area are the enemies in? The Grave Wardens are in Cathedral of the Deep and Untended Graves for DS3. It's your birthday, Dante. Happy birthday. Yo, someone else's birthday was earlier in the stream. I will sing you happy birthday. Happy goddamn birthday! Huh! Check! Random awkward birthday. There you go. Ronaldo, what's up? Was it my birthday? No, it's not my birthday. My birthday's next year. That was very creepy. It was supposed to be creepy. Alright, let's go to the bright bugs. Nice. Yeah, dragon rider turtles quite a bit. Also, I'm kind of stupid for, like, okay, so there's a thing that will get us more stamina, which is safer. And I pulled it off, but I didn't do the right thing to follow it up. So if you get two shots, if you get the falling shot on the dragon rider that snipes, you don't have to do two R2s, you just do a running R1 and an R1. But I didn't do that, which was dumb, because then I put my stamina at a point that was pretty dangerous, whereas if you only get one shot, you have to do the two R2s to kill him. That's basically all you do. So I didn't actually have to use that much stamina. That was a mistake. Other than that, that was pretty good. Why no light armor for more protection? Uncle, we're doing a no-hit run, so I can't get hit by an enemy, which means that I don't really need the protection, because their game's over if I get touched by an enemy. So that's how it works. But if you didn't know that, now you do. Welcome. I don't know why this is hitting the wall. I have to do this again because he was like a foot, a couple feet too far away. That sucks. Has SL1 been done on DS1? No hit? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Well, I do have this glove on, Lalderman. I got the pimp glove. We're using Havel's armor for poison through attacks. Only a few runs haven't been done before. Well, at this point, I think every major run has been done. Like, I think it's more particular ones that haven't been done that are just extra, right? But the major things have been done. For me, this is one major thing I haven't done, but there's only one person that even tried it, really. Well, actually, sorry, a couple people tried it other than the guy that got it, but it's not a surprise that people don't really want to do this particular run. It's definitely the worst SL1. Dude, this guy's foot is literally invincible. Finish watching your old no-hit SL1 run on DS3. Really amazing stuff. Well done there. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. What challenge am I the most proud of? The trilogy, for sure. Trilogy was, Trilogy was really, really hard. Because Trilogy wasn't just playing good, but you had to actually mentally change to be able to really pull it off like that. I feel like that was, like, the biggest mental lesson overall. Like, just having to convince yourself that you're not actually doing it and believe that you're not doing it to be able to do it. Because it's so hard. Once you've already had two games down, like, it just keeps coming back in your mind. So to be able to control that is harder than actually playing the game, in my opinion. So. Somebody's here earlier than I expected. Hi, how's it going? Thank you.
Good.
I was actually just drinking coffee, now I got another coffee because BB brought coffee.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Ice coffee.
Well,
from the Tim Hortons.
Yeah. They're not sponsored, the stream. The stream's not sponsoring Tim. Or wait, what? No, why would the stream sponsor Tim Hortons? That doesn't make any sense. They don't need.
They basically are, considering how much coffee we drink from there.
They should, yeah, they it would be them sponsoring us.
Yeah. Hi, Chad. How are you guys today?
People were trying to break the record of the most ease in chat.
Oh gosh,
when I took a break.
Today. True's here, that's why.
Yeah, it's his fault.
You're an instigator.
True's the guy that the elderly folk in the neighborhood, that no good True on my lawn again. I'm gonna call the cops on you, young man. Where are your parents anyways?
I'm home early because we might be forgetting the keys today.
Okay.
So I'll go pick them up.
Oh, you're gonna get them today?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
Yes, if I was free, so.
It's a good excuse to get off work early.
Well, I gotta get all the stuff, so.
Yeah, that's true.
Anyway.
Yay!
Yay!
Step number 37 out of 400 for getting a new place. 41-AC. What day are you moving on? We're moving in a couple days. Did you ask her if we're able to bring stuff over tomorrow?
I'll ask her.
Okay. Back to Ots where you came from. Ots where you came from. Wait, what happened? I didn't understand that. Bibi doesn't like you, true? I think she likes you.
I do like
she's
you.
She's bullying you because she likes you more than me. I didn't get the bright bugs. Oh, I am so silly. Let me go back and get bright bugs. I knew there was something missing.
Did you?
Yeah, I knew it. So we gotta set up RTSR again, unfortunately, but we also gotta go buy these items.
Did they get the E's or no?
No, they didn't beat the E's.
Aww.
Not quite.
Poor things. Tomorrow's another day.
Yeah. Here are the bright bugs.
Thank you, God.
You meant to say go, not to. Oh yeah, Otstarva, he's crazy. I recommend following him if you like this game. I don't know if he's going to be doing anything else on it, though. He got his all-boss run, so he's been playing Dead by Daylight. Is he still trying to do no rolling, no hits on this? Maybe he'll go back to SL1. Who knows? Alright, let's see. So we got one of these, then we got the second one, then we want to set up right here, I think. It should be RTSR right there. Almost. He got the no roll a while ago. Yeah, I was wondering if he was going to do something else with it, but maybe that's enough for him for now. He's doing really good on Dead by Daylight anyways. I'd just continue playing that. Is it possible to do SL1 all boss DS2? It's possible, but it's very improbable though. It's much more improbable than this. I mean, if you've seen how long it's taken for me to just even get consistency, or somewhat of consistency on this, imagine more than twice the amount of content, but then all the stuff added, most of which is harder than the stuff that you do in this, you know, except for maybe a few things. And the areas are worse. He's streaming Dead by Daylight now. Yeah, I'm glad he's doing so good on it. Like, it's always nice seeing people succeed like that. Especially when, like since he's been working pretty hard to grow on Dead by Daylight, like, he wasn't pulling as many viewers as his average for, like, a long time, but he stuck with it, and then he actually managed to pull it off, you know? It's awesome. It's a good example for other people that want to branch out, I think. And there's actually a lot of people that play Souls playing that game now, which is cool. We can get our revenge now. Nice. Would you ever do the god run that Hob did? I tried to, Orangey Cat. I did the trilogy and then I got to Bloodborne and beat probably more than half of it and then I died. I probably could have gotten that run. I just didn't have as much time as he did on it. I only played that run for like 2 months, so I think he was on it for a year or so, right? Or like the better part of a year, because he also worked the trilogy into it. I kind of just jumped into it right away. No scholar? This is scholar right now. 7 hour long YouTube series about how bad DS2 is, then you bought the game. That sounds like YouTube when it comes to this game. Yeah, definitely sounds accurate. So I'm gonna light this just in case. Even though we probably don't really need to go back. I'm also gonna pause the music here just so I can hear a little bit better. Ever done any challenge runs for Demon Souls? I tried to no-hit Demon Souls. I got 2 hits on it. I also tried SL1 a while ago, and I gave up on it because it wasn't fun, because I wasn't really that knowledgeable on Demon Souls itself. When I did SL1, I was pretty bad at the game. It was the main problem. This guy knows I'm there. Or does he? He does now. It's a little scary. Thankfully, I got his arm. I mean, these guys are so crazy, man. Also, I'm probably not going to read chat too much during this area, like the whole thing, just so I can focus. Because it is a pretty silly part of the game. So here is where we pull the 3 million IQ strategy, and I lure these guys. I shouldn't need the mace, so I'll take the mace off. But we'll use a regular arrow to set this up. And then he should come over here, walking right into our trap. And the regular arrow actually does the preliminary damage to them, too. So that's really good. Look how far away you can hit them with that bow. See how crazy, like, that's how hard it is to use the crossbow if you want to, just an idea. You know? Like, isn't that stupid? That this bow goes that far, but the crossbow doesn't, you know? Like, that's so far away. That is so incredibly far away. Okay, I missed him on that. We actually should just take this guy out right here, I think. This guy in the water. Unless this dude might actually see me, though. He might start coming over here. I don't even know. How's my sanity, Weissman? I'm doing pretty good. Is it raining out over here? Doesn't sound like it. It did rain last night. I don't know if it's raining again right now. I can't hear anything. What's your plan after completing this run? I'm trying to complete this so I can get practice to do it in a trilogy marathon. So all three games, SL1, no hits, is the goal. It's what we're gonna start on right after. And by then I should have enough practice to do this well. Oh, this is really annoying. She, like, I don't understand how I didn't hit her. It doesn't make any sense. Does it? Does it really make any sense? Like, this is also a dumb reason to have a mistake or whatever. And I don't think this will stop. I'm pretty sure she won't de-aggro. So now we're in a loop. Well, there's not too much that can be done, as far as I know. I can try to run away. I don't want to look away, though. I see, like, you saw that I hit her, and then it worked, and then I actually went even closer, I think, and it didn't work. So that's really stupid, unfortunately. Can try to run, see if it works. Get in the cave there. In before Forlorn. Forlorn invasion in Amana is actually pretty easy. I should be fine if Forlorn invades. Forlorn can't, he can't even invade until after. And look how long she shoots it for, too. Like, that's just wild, dude. This is just so wild. I can't believe the arrow went through her body. Like, it was like a mid part of her, too. After I already had hit her at that distance. Oh, the headshots on this guy actually do more damage. I didn't know that. That's interesting. You want me in Smash? What would I even do, though? Just not get hit by things or something? Enemies chase you for miles. Yeah, the aggro in this game is really, really weird. Like, it's extremely odd that enemies act the way they do in a lot of cases. Just the behavior in general in this is just super weird. Like, it's just... And they'll do things that seem like they wouldn't do them, and then it throws you off just enough to make a mistake because you expect them to be a little bit more functional. And they're not. They don't function properly sometimes. Then they'll throw you... at an enemy that does function properly, and then you get screwed because it actually is a decently programmed enemy. Yeah, there's some weird rules with the way this goes. I am using Stone Ring, yeah. I don't know if it affects this, though. I don't know if it matters with the crossbow. All my moves are parries. Bare hand parry pontiff. It's a special. Yeah, Bloodborne will be my favorite out of the Souls games, for sure. If you want to include that. Let's see if we can get the headshot on this guy. Not quite. Oh, we got it on the second one, though, because he goes down the hill. That's nice. That was weird because it just wouldn't let me lock him right away, and I should have. Was that a no-scope? That was a no-scope, and then I locked after I shot, which probably means it didn't do anything to the shot, so I was actually aiming in a really good direction. Crossbow crossbow looks overpowered. I have it upgraded to the most it can go, and I'm using some of the best arrows on it. Plus, my damage is boosted by 20% because of the ring I'm wearing, so this isn't the damage it would do if you didn't have all those things in place. So there's definitely things assisting the damage more than anything else. It's also raw infused, so for SL1 that gives you a bonus. Gives it flat damage. I mean, the biggest punishment when it comes to crossbow is the time it takes. Okay, I'm gonna have to kill these guys because this thing's taking forever. I went out early and then she started firing, so I gotta wait for the de-aggro. So, the way we do the setup for this is weird, so I gotta put the mace back. That'd be good. So I believe I take the ladle off, two-hand offhand, but have the mace so I can buff immediately, then put the ladle back on after the buff. And then Brightbug. We had really good timing on that. That was perfect. That was done really well. Brightbug first. I just buffed twice. Rip Brightbug. Don't have time for it now, unfortunately. Unless I use it on a move, as she does. Did you just say she, Casey? I think Demon of Song is a she, but I don't know. Maybe not. I have no idea, dude. There's a lot of really weird things. We don't have time to make sense of them. All right, let's see. We get this right around here. It's not quite. Is it the door? No. Why is it not working? Oh, maybe I'm not close enough. He's aggroing me, but he's not turning around yet. Is it the wall? Yes, there we go. Okay. Hmm. On what split is the big dragon, Lollerman? The one after this one. I don't actually have a segment for Guardian Dragon. So Giant Lord's pretty big. Like, I should actually add two more segments to this run. I should make it Veldstat, Guardian Dragon, Dude on the Stairs, and then actually have Giant Lord. So there should be two more splits, technically. Since Giant Lord's segment goes on forever. Dingo Ryan, I got Red Tearstone, Mace plus 10. If you have Ring of Blades, Red Tearstone active, Mace plus 10, and then you get a backstab on them, you should be able to one-shot them. It is a backstab, but I mean, like, backstabs are pretty annoying to get in this. Right here, what dude on the stairs? The Dragon Covenant guy. Right here, though, I actually have to find a way to get this one to turn. I don't know how to do it properly, though. I think I need the upper part of the door. Oh, he already blocked, which is unfortunate. So we'll just kill him. This is going to take a while. I'll have to repair powder this. I can't seem to get this one to turn from the sound cue, unfortunately. Dude on the stairs, best enemy. I hate the guy on the stairs. But now, because we were very frugal, and that just means I accidentally didn't use the item I was supposed to use on Demon of Song, we can use the Bright Bug on the guy on the stairs. And then still have two left for the late game, which is really good. Imagine being a boss, but being degraded to a dude on the stairs. He's not actually a boss, though. He's just a regular enemy. He's a very, very large health pooled regular enemy that can do anything that you can do. But he's got really, really strong weapons and a good armor set, and you don't have much space to maneuver, considering how dangerous he is on this run, so. He's the assistant manager to Guardian, to Ancient Dragon, actually. You remember when he hit you on the God run for your PB? Yeah, he hit me on this run too recently. And I regret not using the Bright Bug. And then I practiced the same part again off stream, and I found out an even better way to do it, so. Apparently you can bring him through the entire area. You can go all the way back to the beginning. I think as long as you don't go out of the area completely, like, you can go all the way back, so. There was never really a reason to even have a problem on him. I just didn't know that was possible, because you get killed if you go up the stairs too far. Okay, now we can just bait this guy. Julian, what's up? How's it going, man? Is there a cheese strat for the dragon guy? It's not really, like, it's pretty cheesy, but it's not really, like, you can still totally get hit by him. You just have to keep a good distance. The basis of it is that you can go through the whole area backwards, whereas you can't go up through the stairs with him or you'll get killed, because it'll count as running away from him, basically. But you can go, like, the whole area counts as a battleground for dueling him without the other guys getting mad at you. So that's good. Do you kill the big dragon? Ancient dragon? No, he's not a part of this. He just gives us the item we need.
Thank you.
Do headshots up the damage on what in particular? On some enemies they do. I'd say most enemies, yeah. You know, you're right. Most enemies they do actually prove to be better. Like sometimes you actually get a stagger for hitting the head too. That thing right there always happens and it's so scary. I have to tell myself to not freak out during that, but it's terrifying though. Like it's actually kind of funny, you get punished more the quicker you are on that part, so I could be slower by a bit, but then it's like kind of like a pinch, so there's an enemy that will chase you that is so much faster than you are if you wait too much longer there. But then on the alternative, there is the fact that you will not get killed by the... or you won't have a close call on the magic, right? That's nice. Isn't there an NPC invasion? We killed her earlier in the game, so she doesn't invade. In DS1, if you headshot Quailag's human head, you can infinitely stagger her. Yeah, that's... probably one of the best examples of it.
Very true.
I kind of want to use the crossbow on Velstad. I've never done that before. Should try to make that a thing. Terrifying. Boy. Sketchy. Monka S times 10,000. There's Velstad. Am I going the right way? I remember I get so disoriented after that I went the wrong way last time and I ran into the Dragon Rider. That's funny. Will you kill the king who roams around the room? No, we don't have to kill him. He is not necessary. So the all that's left is Guardian Dragon, Giant Lord, Throne Watcher, Defender, and Ashandra. That's it. So we're going back here. What's up with the black sleeve, large frog? That's the peasant's gloves. So with that and the ladle, we get one extra iframe. Actually, now we gotta switch this for King's Ring, don't we? And put the crossbow back on.
GG.
Cody, thank you for the GG. I appreciate it. Thank you very much, man. So we could try to bait this guy. Or we could just kill him. Killing him is definitely much better, in my opinion. Why not? Why not just kill him right now? Because he has this weird, really weird long-range attack I only figured out today. I'd never seen it before today. Where he just starts running at you. That was the most passive-aggressive way you've heard anyone say GG. That's why the donations are even better for text-to-speech messages, because that guy's even funnier than the TTS lady, in my opinion. How did you get hit in Giant Lord area? Oh, I got hit on Giant Lord himself, because I couldn't... Like, I got a bad camera angle, and I wasn't looking up. I also wasn't trying to influence the direction he was going in enough. So that happened. Glad you're here to watch this one live. Obscure, it's not over yet, dude. Not over yet. The hardest part of the game is like minutes away, so. Or maybe like 10 minutes away. 15 minutes away. But I appreciate it, though. I appreciate your belief. I am a believer as well. No pressure, Vape Dad? I don't really feel any pressure right now. I kind of want to just drink my coffee, but I don't want to stop playing either. Can you say hi, YouTube, because this is the run, Pro Noob? If you want to, go for it. I can put chat on the screen if we actually get it, if you really want to say hi, YouTube. Did you just quote Smash Mouth? Did I? I don't know. Yeah, I would say most of you are probably more stressed than I am at the moment, for sure. That's usually how it is. Okay, perfect. Easy RTSR. Ost just said that I'm a unit, and he respects that I'm doing this, did he? Nice. Well, I appreciate that he's, he approves of my DS2 skills. Because he's the DS2 king right now. He is the master of the Drang Lake.
Just don't get hit. It's so easy. Actually, you could probably do it. No pun intended.
Complete one and three. No. This is just SL1 by itself on DS2. I haven't gotten this run before, so it's a pretty big deal for me. Be able to just do it. It's a good achievement.
Just don't get hit.
So do we want to use a bright bug for this or not? We have three left if we use one for here, so I might as well buy another three. One for Dragon Guy, one for Throne Watcher Defender, one for Nishandra. Pretty easy. Oh, I always split on this. It's so weird. I shouldn't be doing that. My bad. I was skeptical of going for that last swing right there.
Just a door to get at the core field here.
Cody, thank you again. Oh wait, sorry, did I say Cody? Corey. Thank you. I think that was Corey. Thought you didn't notice. Giuliano? Oh, you thought I didn't notice the last hit? No, I'm paying attention, don't worry. I think we're past the point of the baby damage resets. Unless it's like a basic enemy that always dies in a certain amount of hits that does like a weird thing. It is Cody, not okay, there's Corey, then there's Cody. There's two Corys, and then there's one Cody. I apologize. Or at least that I know that have been around lately. Thank you very much, man. I apologize. I was right the first time, I should have just stayed with that. Because I glanced as it disappeared, kind of. Their butt cheeks crossed for me, thanks. I appreciate it, I think. I think that's a good thing. Do you have to kill Ancient Dragon? No, not on this run. So we have Giant Lord, Throne Watcher, Defender, and Nishandra left, that's it. Let's go, dude on the stairs time, pretty much. Time for the dude on the stairs, so. Oh, I gotta go buy more bright bugs, though. I lit the bonfire in that cave, didn't I? I'm gonna have to make a trip back. Unless I do them without a bright bug. I could. But there's no RTSR setup over here, so I have to go back. Yeah, I guess we'll do it without it. Because then I can use a bright bug for Giant Lord instead. It's not a big deal. Like with the strat that I was practicing, I should be fine. I'm not really worried about this guy as much as Throne Watcher Defender, Giant Lord. Will there be more violence this run? Oh yeah, for sure. Don't risk it. Well, it's not really risky to not use the bright bug. It just takes a little bit longer. I just have to backpedal a little bit longer through the area. I can go all the way back to here and kill him though. And he also starts slowing down a lot once you get to this area, like, so he doesn't run at you as much. No RTSR. No, we have RTSR. I just need, I wouldn't be able to get it if I warped back from this bonfire. I'd have to go all the way back from there again and then walk back, so. Shoot, just shoot his legs. Look, it does the same thing. 38 damage. Pro noob, have a good rest of your day. I'll see you later, man. If you die on the bright due to dragons breaking it, will it be considered a reset? On the bridge, yeah, that's a reset. Can't die on the bridge. It's pretty easy to get across there, though. It takes a long time for them to break it, from what I remember. Can you kill the dragons that fly around? Those ones? No, they're just, they're just there. Like Bourne's hammer. Kind of looks like a birdcage or something on a stick. Like a really heavy maximum security bird prison or something like that. Oh shit. He's like, what was that? He sees me. He's like, oh, nothing. Carry on about your day. Just shooting arrows at the staircase. No big deal. Awkward. This game is so hard to like compared to the others. I can understand why. I think we've gone over that quite a bit already, but you're right though. You're definitely right. It's the ugly duckling of the three. Or the weird child, I guess you could call it. So one thing that I've noticed is when you're locked onto this dude, he behaves differently in the beginning. So I should have done that right away. I forgot I practiced that. It's part of what I was trying to figure out. so scary when the other ones move. It's not even the other ones moving that scares me. It's me shooting an arrow and him moving out of the way of it, and then the arrow hitting the guys that are waiting, because then you have like 30 enemies on you. Then you're actually dead. That's why in this area it's so dangerous, because he just has to move to the side and an arrow can just go in the background and get one of these guys. It's like the worst part. Doesn't that bridge break if you break a certain amount of eggs? I think that's how you do it, yeah. You have to break the eggs. Pretty sure. Accidentally hitting one of the other guys, yeah, that's really what you don't want to do. It's the worst thing. Okay, we got the Ashen Mist Heart. I think on this run, I don't know if I got the Forlorn door open, but I practiced. I don't know if I have an extra skull or not. I practiced doing a thing where I can get Forlorn out of the way, because I got a Forlorn invasion when I was playing the rest of the game. And it seems like he doesn't actually follow you through the whole area. So, you can't get into the giant dream, or the giant's memory, if Forlorn invades, which is really weird.
Oh wait, we gotta get more bright bugs though. The bright bugs, no!
Yeah, minus one means that I have one less hit than my PB up to this point. So we're ahead by one from the best I've done overall. Use dim bugs instead of bright bugs. You think that they won't expect that, right? It's less obvious to use dim bugs. It's a really good call. It's not a lot of damage. Second rung, I think. Yeah. Well, that's good enough. Super awkward. Just like dies like a crazy ragdoll inside an industrial fan. Yeah, so Forlorn does invade. Let me just double check this door. It's not open, so we have to go through the area pretty much. Or we just go back to where the bonfire is and go in a circle and escape. Although, killing him is pretty hard, so we'll probably have to go all the way around to get rid of him reliably. Probably worth killing this guy really quick, isn't it? Actually, it's not. Ugh. So here, do we have skulls? We don't have any skulls, okay. Which is fine, I just need fire bombs. Kill this guy quick, just in case. I don't really think Forlorn makes it this far, that's the thing. And then the RTSR will kill me, so I have to heal that really fast. I don't know if he actually makes it over here. Have to see. I'll see him right now. He did the quick attack. I was expecting that. That's good. Okay. This guy's alive right now, which is really sketchy. Doing some Mission Impossible shit there. But then this fog gate's already open, so we just pull these guys. We just get both their attention and then get them to chase me. And then we can send Forlorn home. The one is right there, though. I don't like that. He's pretty slow, so we're good. Five Lorn instead of Forlorn. Look at this guy's body just freaking out over there. What's going on? What's the deal? Oh, then we got this guy in the hallway, who's super scary. Oh no, this guy's scary. I'm gonna just go in here with the crossbow charged already. Because this guy's freaking me out already, just as it is. Just thinking about him. Get out of here. And this is how you send Forlorn home. Just gotta do that all over again. Quite a lot of effort, but yeah, that's how you do it. That jump with no damage, wow. Oh, do you mean like the big, well the big, I hit the level that was closer. If I just did the whole jump and jumped over the thing, I'd die. So, one difference is that enemy gets up really quickly if we do it like that. We should be able to survive this. Although it's kind of close now. I might as well just kill this guy so I can take my time. And this one too. Yeah, and this is like the reason why the late game slows down quite a bit, because Forlorn starts invading and then you get careful with things, you got backup plans that take forever, this and that. Imagine losing the Halberd Boy. Oh, that'd be terrible. I would cry. I would actually tear up. That door didn't open, did it? I didn't get close enough. One guy and sits with a flashlight, writes it down with a pencil, while a bunch of the other ones watch meteor shower. Wait, what? Ever go to meteor showers? The secret is to take time when one falls. I don't think I've seen a meteor shower. Personally, no. Fox, thank you for the host. How was your stream, dude? Let's get the bright bugs ready. Oh boy, bright bug for this part. Sign me up. Oh boy, I'm excited, okay. So even if the giant tries to pull something funny, I can actually have a chance on this. I'm just gonna use it right away so it applies to the small ones too. This guy's really close to me though, I gotta be careful. Sucks. This might not be good. Okay, one of them is gonna die, I think. At least one will die. Oh, they both did. Cool. Cool. That's good. Good. I could not see there. Oh, that was so bad. You just can't see anything. It's so fucking hard.
That was terrifying.
That was so bad. This entire run is so scary. Jesus, man. So scary. Lots of PB, though. Would have been a hard choke. I actually did choke there a little bit, because I thought I hit his foot. I could not see. You just don't want it to get against the wall like that. It's so bad. So DS1 after you get this. I can try. Yeah, I can try. I probably would do DS3 after I got this. I think I'd prefer that. Leave the ring on still. That's good. Is that PB? That's a PB for me for distance. Getting there. You hit the wall and ran out of stamina. Exactly. Jim, what's up? How's it going, man? Notice me, senpai. Goz, thank you for the good luck. I appreciate it. Yeah, like the thing with Thronewatch and Defender, I don't really even think there is good RNG. I don't know what that even means, because they just chase you around and they just swing at you randomly. They'll shoot projectiles. Although, okay, Watcher will shoot projectiles once in a while. Those aren't that bad, but I don't even know what bad RNG or good RNG looks like on it. I think it's just mostly the same. It's just mostly terrifying. Okay. If you get this, then you'll attempt the trilogy after this. I'll try to. We'll see. Look at all those souls. Holy shit. Do you need to kill the giant, and why? Giant Lord? It's just required to get into the throne. Trilogy SL1 has not been done. No, Hob is going to attempt it on August 5th. Apparently. Switch King Ring? It doesn't matter. We don't need the third ring slot, or the fourth. I'm just going to calm down a second before I go in here, just because, like, this fight's gonna be pretty long, I think. It's gonna take a while. Stole two books from his girlfriend. They were so awesome. Wait, what are we talking about? Berensky's just saying telling stories. Can do BL4 any percent 3 times in a row. That doesn't count. Okay.
Only go when you're ready.
Okay. We did it. Nice. Oh boy. That was so fucking hard. That was so hard. My heart actually like hurts right now. It's beating so hard that it hurts. Oh my god.
Congrats on the PB, Squilla.
Oh.
So glad my message didn't mess you up.
Oh boy. Oh boy. That's a dude, honestly, I gotta say congrats to Papa Finn for doing this run first, because he's fucking crazy. It's so hard. It is so ridiculous. Oh, I didn't think that last part would be that bad.
G, my dude, 10 colon, 10 colon, 10 colon, 10 colon, 10 colon, 10 colon, 10.
Thank you again, Cody. Kittenzilla, thank you for the 17 months. Welcome back.
So the world might be mine. Cheers to you. Nice.
I'm just trying to like
pop Pikachu, pop Pikachu.
Yeah, I'm just trying to catch like make my heart rate slow down. Oh boy.
You.
It was worse on Throne Watcher Defender, but it's better now.
The fire strength be granted.
Like, I don't feel a pulse. He's lying. He doesn't have a heart.
I don't feel a pulse. He's lying.
So the world might be
it's fine now.
Nice run.
Did
you take my money?
To embrace pound there.
It was pounding. Lalderman, thank you for the 2 months. Welcome back, dude. I appreciate it. Also, thanks to BB for letting me use her computer while we're in the process of moving to do this run.
Welcome.
Also, wait, let me... Oh, I can't show chat on screen unless I do monitor capture, right? Yeah, I can't. Sorry, guys, I said I'd put chat on screen. I kinda can't do that.
You can try.
We need, window capture, but it doesn't work, though.
Great sovereign. Take your throne.
No one else has already done a minimum level no hit run in 4 of the 5 games. That's pretty impressive. As far as you know, wait, no one's done a minimum no hit run in 4 or out of 5 of the games. Wait, what do you mean by that? Streamlabs and chat cap link as source. Oh, okay. Seasoning, thank you for the sub, man. I appreciate that. Welcome, dude. Also, the frickin' who was that just did that? I didn't catch it in time. Whoever just did the 10 bones, thank you. Did anybody what was the name? I'm sorry. Oh, you're saying I've done the most unleveled runs, no hits in the entire series. Okay. Seasoning. What is going on, dude? Thank you for the 10 gifted subs. I really appreciate that. I hope everybody that just got gifted a sub, that you enjoy your emotes, and please, please thank Seasoning for that. Thank you so much, man. Guys, thank you for putting up with this for a few weeks. So we got it before the Bloodborne tournament, which was my goal. Even though I know that I can't fully control that, like, I wanted to try pretty hard to get it. That was over 3 weeks of attempts. Papa Finn, thanks for helping me do this as well by making the route for it and everything. Oh, it was you mediocre? Thank you, dude. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. All right, I don't have any game music, so it's just kind of quiet right now, and I've paused the music of the game for a while, or the music we were listening to, which is here. So now it's kind of like we have music. We're gonna switch over to DS3, I guess, and try that. See how that goes. If that's okay with you, are you?
Yeah. Do you care if I go to my brother's later, maybe?
For what?
Dinner and endgame.
Oh, for Avengers?
Mm-hmm.
Endgame?
Yeah.
Oh, he hasn't seen it before?
I don't know.
He just wants to watch it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, sure. Go for it, yeah.
Okay.
What time is that at?
I could go now.
Okay. I guess it's a long stream, guys.
I said I'd let him know, because I didn't know what your plans were.
Yeah.
So.
What Bloodborne tournament? There's a Bloodborne tournament that Lethal is organizing. I don't have a command for it yet.
Lethal, are you here? We should update the command.
Also, I like this ending takes so long to get through. I want to see what my playtime was before we actually quit the game. So I'm going to leave it through all the credits. We'll just talk for a moment. I'm going to change the title and switch over to DS1 right after. So,
congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, something weird happens on your game where it flashes at this part of the credits. It happened before.
Oh.
That's weird. Okay, so we're changing over to Dark Souls 1 after this is over with. change the title though. Oh man, Jerome, dude. Jerome, thank you for gifting five subs. I hope you guys enjoy your emotes, courtesy of the Jerome Meister. Also, please follow Jerome if you don't already. He's organizing a lot of no-hit tournaments for these games. He's done a lot for the community overall, and for me even, just individually. So please give him some love if you can follow him. Follow Lethal as well. Follow everybody that streams here. I'm just going to give shoutouts to some people. Wait, is Lethal's name have a number still?
Let's do at Lethal.
Lethal 3. There we go. Follow all these people. And then we're also going to give a shout out to Papa Finn, because he was the first person to do this run. The only other person I know of on the planet that has done this. The only other person that understands the pain. Fox, thank you for gifting 5 subs also, dude. You guys are crazy. You guys are nuts. I'm still trying to calm down. I'm like shaky. I think it's because I've had so much caffeine. Like, I was literally drinking a coffee already, and then BB brings me another coffee, and I'm already done half of each, and we're mixing and matching the coffee.
Yeah, you're shaking pretty good. His hands are like, what?
Yeah, I got the jitters for sure. Cool. Maybe that helped, though. Maybe that helped.
Yeah.
Hob next. Yeah, I'll give a shout out to Hob. Why not? All these people you gotta give follows to. Otsdarva, another good shout out. If you're watching on YouTube and you're still here at this point of the video, go follow all these people that I just mentioned. Not only do you find your voice calming, but also my puppy. Wait, your puppy? Wait, what does that mean? Thank you, I appreciate it, but wait, what's the puppy thing about?
I think your puppy finds it calming.
Oh, your dog finds the stream entertaining? That's cool. Deathmatch in Square Room in Doom 2. You killed lots of people with Super Shotgun. I'm about to conk out. We got to get hyped for DS3. We're going to do DS3 now. We're going to get a streak going. And then if we can get DS3, we already have a good PB for the trilogy. But this isn't the end. We're going to have to do DS2 again. This is just the first taste of the victory. So The second one who did this ever. Yeah, for a good reason. Because this run is just ridiculous, man. Mm-hmm. Oh. Throne Watcher and Defender is so scary because, like, it's best to not lock on to them, but it's so hard to manage the camera and see everything going on at once. Huh. Oh boy. Are you going to change the counter? Or do we have the trilogy counter still?
We should.
We might have the trilogy counter. Although I will say, if we do fail DS3, we'll probably practice DS1 a little bit before we end.
I'm just going to fix this because of the whole minus one thing.
That's because my PB?
No, but that shouldn't be in that column in the first place.
Oh, okay. Are you going to stream more today? Oh, yeah, we're going to continue. I'm just waiting for the credits to end on this so I can check the playtime because I'm curious of how fast we did it. I think it was probably 2.5 hours, roughly, but I want to see. And then we're going to switch to DS3. Try to get a streak on that. RFGS, yeah, we did. We did it, man. Finally. Credits are like 7 minutes on this, aren't they? Can we change the title to Squillagy? I'll change it to Squillagy once we're actually, like, attempting it officially. Because, well, I guess we are attempting it officially now, right? Mm-hmm. Once we get back on my setup, I'll change it to Squillagy. I'll make a thing for it. We'll get a thing for it. Should do an E-train just to celebrate. Oh god. The credits are still going on this game. So the story with the credits are, I have to wait because you can't skip them if it's the first playthrough of the game that you've done, unfortunately.
Do they just do that?
And it's flashing for some reason too. I don't know why it does that. I think it might be your graphics card or something on your computer. It did that when I was practicing too.
Okay, nobody touch anything.
We fix it. No one breathe. The epilepsy warning is over. The run was too powerful for the game. Oh boy. Also, we should get the deathless ring as well, which proves that we didn't cheat on deaths at least or anything. Imagine you'll finish all the SL1s today. What will you do then? Oh, I'll freaking cry, dude. If we get the trilogy right now, on the first time I ever completed the SL1 on DS2, I will cry. And then I'll go buy a Lamborghini and then take it back like 2 days later. Oh man. Thank you guys for being here today. And for anyone that came from Otstarva's stream or another person's stream that recommended us, you were here for something really cool. For sure. SL1, no hit, no monitor. Oh boy. Did the DS1 run? I haven't done DS1 yet. We're gonna do 3 right after this, and then we're gonna do 1 last. Would I continue to Bloodborne if I get the SL1 trilogy? I don't have the PS4 set up, so probably not. If I knew the Demon Souls SL1 run, I'd do it for fun, but like, I don't want to seriously attempt all 5 games right now.
Congrats, Squilla. Keep up the good work.
Demon Souls SL1.
Demon Souls SL1 you can do really easily with magic, but without magic it's hard though. It's like a harder version of the other ones. There's the ring that we got. Salt, thank you for the 2 months. Welcome back. Man, is Bearded Belgian in chat? He always is asleep whenever I'm doing runs. He was complaining about that. If he's here, then that means we've succeeded, because he's seen a run then. Okay, what's the time on this? Let's see. Why is there no load game? Aw, 252, that's pretty slow. Okay, whatever. Whatever. Boo, you suck, get off the stage. Washed up.
Not sub 2 hours.
Ew. Should I keep the...